A moment of awakening when I love this job. Come here, I want to show you how much I love the job. Look at this. My wheels are my freedom. I had this Park Avenue bitch in here. Oh my God, she was about 60 years old, plastic surgery to the hilt, looked pretty good. So when you start out, you try to make a little small talk just to be friendly. So she barks at me, because you're allowed to bark at the lower classes. And she's like, excuse me, I'm not paying you for the conversation, I'm paying you for the transportation. So like a little slave, I drove, I meeked myself out and I drove a little while longer. And then I realized, hold on, I am a small business owner. I don't have to take this. So I turn around, ma'am, excuse me, but I'm gonna have to ask you to disembark from my pedicab until you could speak to all people in a kindly manner. And she's like, why, I never. And then as I pulled away, I was like, by the way, nice tits. And that's when I fell in love with my baby, who keeps me off the matrix and free.
The hardest part of the pedicab driving industry is not driving, it's actually getting that customer on board.
Do you live in the city?
I do.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm looking for tourists. You see right here. Hello, Mira. How you doing? I want to show you something interesting. You want to give a view of it? How you doing, guys? Do you guys have a second for me? You have 2 seconds for me? Information? I told you how hard it is, right? You see? But I'm going to make it. Today I'm not lucky, but that's the hardest part of the job. Get the customer, convince them, and put them in the pedicab. That takes a lot of headaches.
My company is actually the longest running pedicab company in New York City. We grew out of the very first kind of project, which was called Ponycab, or Pedicabs of New York. Different kinds of wheeled, human-powered transportation were happening around the world. It kind of became influenced by each other, but rickshaw is kind of a English version of jinrikisha. Jinrikisha is a Japanese word that means man, person, right, plus strength, plus carriage. And that eventually got shortened down to rickshaw. The modern pedicab kind of has, you know, 21 speeds and a steel frame and fiberglass body, hydraulic brakes, turn signals. And the whole idea is to give the customer a kind of bicycle type speed.
My name is Gökhan Kayım. I'm from Turkey. I started like 4th of July last year. It was very crowded there, and you know, you need to know rules in the traffic, and it's not like a car, regular cab. You need to stop in the red lights. You cannot use the bike lanes. They have a lot of rules. And first day, I take the ticket. Officer wrote a ticket, and it was not very good day for me, but you know, I started and it's enjoyable.
I've started to call it a practice, you know, so I call the riders practitioners, I call myself a practitioner, you know, like a law firm to practice, you know, for instance, or a doctor has a practice, or you know, somebody who's practicing an art. People say a pedicab driver, but that just doesn't seem like it really captures the essence of what we're doing, you know. Yeah, he beat us, but I go to the back of the line. So this is the key, because these poor people are going to be here for half an hour. You know, so I can usually get them again anywhere in 15 minutes or less. So I like to help them get where they're going, usually. If anybody here is need a taxi, we can go anywhere in Midtown in 15 minutes or less, or we can go anywhere to Houston in 15 minutes or less. If anybody here is important or in a rush, I'd like to focus on you first. Is anybody here important or in a rush? I'm sorry, does anybody here speak English? Vous parlez français? Comprenez-vous, c'est 10 ou 15 minutes au mid-temps avec moi. C'est très vite, c'est très agréable aussi. Nous allons maintenant, c'est pas de problème. Verstehen Sie Deutsch? Ja, es ist sehr schnell mit 10 oder 15 Minuten auf mid-temps. Wir gehen jetzt. It's for toxic taxis. Where are you headed, miss?
40 seconds.
40 seconds and what?
10.
It's gonna take about 7 minutes. You wanna get moving? Okay, come around there. We have a winner, folks. We have a winner. You can talk amongst yourselves in the meantime. Might be back in about 15 minutes.
Hello, my name is Patrick. A good pedicab driver in New York City Central Park. We get other people from Mali, Senegal, Turkey, Russia, Tajikistan, it's different nationalities. So it's like a family. We're all brothers. That's how we call each other. We don't mind the nationality. Everybody's welcome in the area and get to go. And this is my job, like you see it. Get people around the park, make them satisfied, give them some information about the city from its creation, let them know more about the park, guide them, make them have fun, and this is what we do.
I do okay. You know, I don't, certainly not Bill Gates sort of rich or anything like that at the moment. I'm probably not gonna get there doing this exclusively, but you know, if I do this 12 hours a week, say 12 to 15 hours a week, I can pay my rent and I can food and I can pretty much pay my way in New York. I'm not gonna be going on any big trips. I have to work more for that, but you know, it sort of works. It definitely adds up if you get it down pat.
Let me show you here how I work the streets. This is how sad the consciousness of America is. I'm in total agreement with Lady Gaga. Just sell out, put a meat dress on, and be a total whore. Make as much money as you want, because it's hopeless. You gotta find your freedom within the jail. It's a slave's job, it's hard work. If you have to get out there and like, most guys dress like a thug. Like I see these guys, I would never get in, because they're all thugged out. So I said, I find that if you can make people smile, it breaks down the walls. So hence, I find silly cells. So all this nonsense that you see, it's just a creative way to try to make a buck.